Welcome to the Orange Show, where we'll discuss everything that has to do with Houston Dynamo. Yes, my name is Sam. You already know what time it is. This is Africa Sports Network. You can subscribe to our YouTube page. Just go to Africa with a K, Sports with a Z Network, and just click that subscription button so you can help us grow. Also, you can subscribe to all our social media platforms. Yes, the 2022 MLS regular season kicked off over the weekend, and then Dynamo had a home opener, a new coach, his inaugural season, a new owner, first full season, a new GM, and everything looked new for Houston Dynamo this 2022 regular season against ROS. By the end of the day, the game ended in a 0-0 draw. A lot of fans wore long faces as they exit the stadium, you know, following the result that they were not expecting. So I and Chris will chop up all that transpired at the PNC Stadium here on Orange Show, that focus on everything about Houston Dynamo. So I'm going to take you viewers to the PNC Stadium for us to bring to you all the game day shenanigans that took place right there at the PNC Stadium. From halftime analysis to some light refreshment where a female ball juggler entertained the fans. Despite the poor result that some fans experienced, there was something to cheer about. A female ball juggler was right there to entertain the fans. And also, a young fan expressed his opinion about the game. And also, a female fan was so excited despite the result. That shows you different fans have different mindset or have different outcomes when it comes to game day. So this is Orange Show right here on Africa Sports Network. I'll be right back. All right, you're welcome back to the Orange Show with Sam and Chris right here on Africa Sports Network. Yes, week one done and dusted. It was a goal galore in the MLS opening week. 35 goals were scored. Unfortunately, none was recorded at the PNC Stadium as the home opener between Houston Dynamo and Real Salt Lake ended in a goalless draw. New head coach of Houston Dynamo, Paulo Nagamura, opted for Memo Rodriguez and Darwin Seren in the middle. Played a 4-3-3 formation. That shows that he was going for a RSL juggler. But at the end of the day, you know, there was a lot of miscues, misses. The midfield was not alive until halftime. He brought in Darwin Quintero and Coco Carrascuela. That midfield came alive. All right, still on Orange Show right here on Africa Sports Network with Sam and Chris as we take you to the halftime report we did at the PNC Stadium during the game between Houston Dynamo and Real Salt Lake.
This is still around the MLS.
Despite the result,
the PNC Stadium, Houston Dynamo against Real Salt Lake, home game, home opener of the season. In fact, this is the 27th MLS regular season. We forgot to mention that MLS have come along with for it to be their 27th season. That shows that the league have really come along with. I was able to speak to Panosta, the GM of Houston Dynamo, and I asked him, "You played in this league, and we are in our 27th season. Just looking back and looking forward, how far we've come and where we're heading to." What can he say? He told me that when the league started, that 1996 or something, that what they have now is kind of very, very promising. Look at the innovation, development, growth of the league in terms of players, teams, you know, expansion. That's a pointer in the right direction. But here, this is a trophy of Houston Dynamo. Two-time MLS champions. They won the Lamar Hunt US Open Cup in 2018, which is their only trophy they won in over five, years, and the team haven't been in the postseason in the last 4 or 5 seasons. So this season gave the fans a little bit of hope that this might be the season the team might finally be in the postseason to even think about bringing one of these shining, you know, laurels back to the city to make the fans happy. What's your take on that?
Well, as you said, it's been a while they won a trophy. Dynamo is used to winning trophies, but we know they have issues over the past couple of seasons, and now there's a new coach, there's a new owner, there's a new process going up, building the game up better with new players, a new coach. So hopefully, maybe not this season, but coming seasons, they'll be able to build up to the level which they can win another trophy. Like, you know, winning trophies is not easy to win trophy. It takes a proper team to win the trophy.
Planning
players, yes. And those planning sometimes can take 3 or 4 seasons to get the right team to gel enough to win the league. So hopefully, with the new owners, it's like we're starting all over again, the building process. So it might be a while, maybe another 3 to 5 seasons, but hopefully we are moving the right directions right now, and that's why we are hopeful that, you know, very soon another trophy will be here in the PNC Stadium, live and direct in Houston, Texas.
Yes, talking about MLS, you know, when you look at this season, you know, the influx of foreign stars in the league, you know, what does that really show? Looking at Toronto FC, Lorenzo Insigne, Chicago Fire, Zedran Shaqiri, LA Galaxy, Douglas Costa, Houston Dynamo, Beto, Zeca, even though he hasn't arrived yet, and with the news of Hector Herrera coming from Madrid, you know, what does that tell you about the league, looking at the influx of superstars in the league?
It just tells you that the MLS has come of age because of the way the league has matured over the years. If you know right now, a lot of U.S. players are playing professional soccer in Europe.
Yes.
I'm playing in top teams like Barcelona, Juventus, Bayern Munich, Chelsea, just to name a few. It shows that the league now is no longer a retirement ground for players, but now the talents are beginning to come out. The development is beginning to come out. The country as a whole, U.S., is beginning to embrace soccer like you have never before. Today, I think soccer is the fourth most followed sport in the United States, which was never the case in a very long time. So all this coming together is making the MLS itself as a league much more interesting, more exciting. As you said, a lot of players are coming in. The players in LA Galaxy, they just signed Douglas Costa coming in. Just to name a few, HH coming to Houston Dynamo. You know, it's just ongoing, and they're going to have a lot of more players coming in towards other seasons coming up as more players begin to embrace the MLS.
There are more international superstars grace the league. There are also movement of MLS veterans. Someone like Jose Altidore moved from Toronto FC to New England Revolution. They played a 2-2 draw in their opening game. And also, someone like Paul Arriola left DC United to FC Dallas. In fact, he set the record of the highest, you know, fee. Is it I don't know how they call it.
Yeah,
they call
it? A DP?
You know, yeah, not DP. But FC Dallas got some money they gave to DC United to bring Paul Arriola to DC United. And also a lot of other MLS veterans like Kylian Acosta left Colorado Rapids to LAFC. You know, so that shows that in as much as foreign superstars are gracing the league, homegrown stars are also making that movement within the league. And as we about to go back to the stadium to go, you know, take a look at the second 45 minutes, it already started, and I hope that Dynamo will nick it for them to give their fans some to cheer about. This is Sam and Chris, and this is Around the MLS here on Africa Sports Network.
Of that game, a lot of fans had different realities, if I can put it like that. You know, this female fan sounds so excited on the outcome of the result, despite the fact that fans came to the stadium to see the team get 3 points, but some left wearing long faces. This is a female fan.
It was a great game. We had a blast. We love coming to the Dynamo games. It's been 2 years since the opener, so we're just excited to be here.
Nice. But was it a result you wanted to get today?
Obviously, we wanted to score.
True.
You know?
So who was your best player tonight, though? Who played well for you?
Oh, man, I can't say. They all played well. We love the team so much.
Very good. What's your name?
I'm Catherine.
Okay. Can you look in and say, keep on watching African Sport Network?
Say it again.
Keep on watching African Sport Network.
Of course, keep on watching African Sport Network.
All right, thank you.
On how the team played against Razor Lake. All right, despite the result that came our way on Sunday against Razor Lake, there was something to cheer about, a side attraction, a female ball juggler. Just look at the way, look at her dexterity with the ball. Enjoy this clip. Right, still on Orange Show, right here on Africa's.
The trials, yeah, yeah.
Enjoy this clip. All right, still on Orange Show, right here on Africa Sports Network. Just go to Africa with a K, Sports with a Z, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Follow us on all our social media platforms. Africa Sports Network on YouTube, on Instagram, on Twitter, as we take this program to a different level. Now let's talk to some fans who share different opinions as regard the game. You are still watching The Orange Show with Sam and Chris right here on Africa Sports Network. That was fireworks after the game. Maybe they were, you know, preserving the fireworks in case the
man. What are you expecting before the kickoff time?
Maybe a little aggression.
A little aggression?
Yeah.
You didn't see aggression from the team?
No, man. I was honestly kind of bored. I felt like our team wasn't passing the ball forward enough. They were passing it back all the time. Even when there were opportunities to take a touch in open space and don't turn around and look for where they can pass it and get some aggression going.
Well, where do you think the team could have at least, you know, done a little bit better for them to have gotten a good result tonight?
Well, like I said, I feel like we get into these positions where we could have built up play faster and we were too concerned with playing it safe. It felt like we were okay with the draw. And I wish we would have been pushing a little harder, taking some more risks.
How impressed are you with Sebastian Ferrari?
Honestly, I don't know who Ferrari is.
The guy wearing number 9.
Number 9?
Yeah.
Man, I'm not paying enough attention.
But, I mean, Dynamo wore black tonight. Is it the home color? I thought the home color is orange.
Man, you know, I don't worry too much about the fashion behind it. I
worry because sometimes, you know, some colors might bring a little bit of, you know, good omen. You know what I mean?
Yeah. You think it's luck based?
Not luck based, but at least there are colors that are home color. Like now, if you look around, you see orange everywhere.
Yeah.
That seems to be the home color of Dynamo. But tonight they find out we are in, you know, a shade of black.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that's the reason why they didn't get a win tonight, though.
Don't you think it could be intimidation or, you know, like maybe black is a good color to, you know, assert that we're...
So now they go on the road next weekend against Sporting Kansas at the Children's Macy's Park.
Yeah.
You know, what are we expecting from the team? Why are you laughing like that?
I don't know. I don't think it's important.
All right, man. Yeah, appreciate you, man. This is Around the MLS with Sam. Sam, how you doing?
Yeah,
you're doing good? Yeah. Why are you running from camera? Now you make me focus on you. Now you make me focus on you. You don't run from camera. You know, you run from it, the camera comes to you. You know. So did you watch today's game?
Yes, sir.
How you feel about today's game? How you feel about today's game?
Good.
Good. What about you?
Ready for the season.
What about you?
That was a good game.
What about you?
That was okay.
Okay, before kickoff, what were your expectations of today's game?
I thought it was going to be a little tough. You know, it's almost the whole team. It's new. New coach, under new management. We didn't get like the whole aspect of the team, but hopefully throughout the season, it'll get better and hopefully we get to the finals.
Just the playoffs, huh?
Yeah, that's what we need.
As long
as we get in the playoffs, we should be good.
But don't you think if they had backed up that Ramos the way they are backing up this coach now with new players, do you think Park would have done better?
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Yeah, if it would have been Ted Romo, like back to when new players, how would he have done?
I think Tap Ramos had 2 years already with the current system he was playing. Even with new players, I think they will still perform almost the same, up to par. Because the new players always will give you new for tactics, new excitement in the team. Nothing really much, but the two tactics were still the same, the two formation. Sooner or later, those players will play the same system. Well, Paulo, he tried to do something a little bit different. You can see a little structure on the defense. The midfielder is more wide of playing. Wingers are trying to get more into play, cutting in. So it's going to be a little time because there's still have players. We're still missing Zika with Fab Passport and everything, Visa. There's still a little more difference that it could make as well. Time will tell. He's been only 1 month. So.
All right, the team will go to Real Salt Lake. Yeah. Sporting Kansas this next weekend.
Yeah.
You know, what do you think about that? But hold on, briefly. All right, Derek. What's up, man?
What's up?
How you doing?
I'm good.
That jollof rice, how far? You love chopper?
Good. Yeah, but Nigeria jollof, nah.
You don't
find
trouble.
No problem for Nigeria. Trade that jollof rice no good.
Nigeria jollof rice is no good.
Are you sure about jollof rice? Jollof rice?
I try every restaurant here.
I'll give you for sure one.
Don't worry.
You said that the last
time. I'll give you that jollof rice.
For real, this time.
All right, they go to Sporting Kansas next weekend. When was the last time Dynamo won an away game, if you can remember?
It's a long time, but Kansas is going to be tough. They lost to Atlanta by 3-1, but it was mostly because of Atlanta's counterattacking and pressing that caught Kansas off guard. But Kansas still has a good ball control play. But I think we have a little upper hand. Paulo has known the system for Kansas for a long time.
So he can give us an insight, right?
Yeah, a little insight. But also, we'll see how the spirit of the team up. Hopefully this draw can motivate them to get at least a win or a draw. Away, always away game. Get something out from the opponent is always something better than the losing.
All right, appreciate that. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Who is that? Who got the autograph?
Memo
Rodriguez? Is he your favorite player?
Darwin.
Is he your favorite player?
Yeah.
You like Memo Rodriguez?
No, I like Darwin.
Quintero. El Scientifico, huh? You like him? That's good. So tonight game, did you enjoy it? What can you say a little about today's game? I see you're a third national team. Are you Italian?
Si.
Huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Huh?
So how you doing, sir? How was the game today?
It was pretty good.
Was it a result you expected to get tonight?
No, actually. I thought about winning, but it is what it is.
So what do you think? This is the first game of the season. We got a new coach and a couple of new players. So do you think going forward, Dynamo will be better than how they played last season?
Oh, of course. They're going to come out winning. This is a slow start, but you know, we're going to come out with a good record.
Very good. So, well, who was the most exciting player for you tonight?
The most exciting player for me? All of them.
Nice.
Yeah, you
nice.
Get a little dynamo.
Yeah. Thank you very much for talking. African Sport Network. Thank you.
That was fireworks after the game. Maybe they were, you know, preserving the fireworks in case the team were able to get 3 points. But the team couldn't get 3 points. But at the end of the day, they had to pop. those fireworks. Just enjoy that few minutes clip of the fireworks at the PNC Stadium. Yes, after the goal, let's go against Real. Salt Lake during the Houston Dynamo opening match at the 2022 MLS regular season kickoff. Head coach Paulo Nagamura spoke to the press, and this is his post-match media brief. And also,
first of all, it's Sebastian Ferreira, his name. And look, Real Salt Lake made it really difficult for us. They play with three center backs. They play with, most of the time, five on the back. So it was that difficult to break them. And like I say, on the first half especially, we were a little bit too slow to move the ball. We made it easier for them to defend us.
Okay, we'll go next to Jesus Acevedo. Go ahead.
One out of the way, but overall as a team, I think first half we were a little too slow offensively. What made the game for Salt Lake a little bit easier to defend us. I think second half we came back a little bit more on the front foot, more the way that we want to be, moving the ball a little bit faster, and we're a little bit more playing on their half, what made us to be a little bit more in control of the game. But overall, happy with the defensive performance. Not so happy with the offensive part, but that's something that we can build upon. And that's where I stand right now.
Defender Adam Lindquist was also present at the press briefing. So we're going to hear from both the coach and Adam Lindquist on what they have to say as regard the 0-0 draw against Real Salt Lake. All right, let's go to the full-time report.
It felt amazing to finally start it off. Like, it's been a lot of anticipation and excitement going in to this whole week and for this first game. You know, it's been so long playing in front of our fans, and it was really good to see that many people turn out today. It was amazing. The atmosphere was great. And, I mean, when it comes to the game, I feel like first half we weren't really happy with the level. But we kind of raced a little bit the second half. There's still a lot of stuff to do better, but it was kind of nice to get this first one out of the way. And then, you know, also a clean sheet was very good. Like, as a defender, I always appreciate a clean sheet, and it's a good start to build from.
Great. I'm going to go ahead and get to some of the questions from reporters on here. We'll start with Victor Ariza from the Striker Texas. Go ahead, Victor.
Hey, Adam, kind of want to build on that. Talk about the defensive part of it, but I think obviously fans, you know, left with wanting to win. What did RSL do to, you know, so effectively limit you guys in attack?
I think they were playing like they had a very, you can see, it's a very clear game plan. They wanted to sit very deep and kind of eliminate. I mean, they were playing with five defenders, four midfielders, and one striker, so it's very difficult to get penetration and to get like into these areas where we want to get the ball, and they made the spaces in the middle very, very, very tight, and for our players that we want to get in good positions, it was very difficult to find those spaces. But I think we didn't help ourselves in the first half. We were moving the ball too slow, and I felt like second half was a little bit better. Moving the ball faster would allow us to open some spaces and get our guys in the right spaces and create some more dangerous situations. But no, I think we're in control the whole game, but we're not happy with what we did with our possession. We wanted to have possession with a purpose and create more opportunities. So a lot of stuff to take take from this, but we want to improve.
But as we chop up the game after full-time whistle.
All right, Tom. Welcome to Around the MLS here with Sam and Chris on Africa Sports Network. Full-time score here at the PNC Stadium. Houston Dynamo 0, Real Salt Lake 0. Chris, home opener, home debut for the new coach, Paulo Nagamura. Some players made their debut. Steve Clark, Sebastian Ferrari, all made their debut.
Tom made his debut too.
You know, Tom made his debut today for Houston Dynamo. By the end of the day, they couldn't get across the hump. I mean, let me get your honest assessment as regards today's play.
Well, it's a little bit disappointing. Like, everyone wanted Dynamo to go ahead and take the victory, being the first game of the season. And everyone's anticipating the fact that there's a new coach, a couple of new players that were signed in. But the game didn't go according to plan. First half was a little bit stiff. Rodriguez in the middle wasn't playing according to the way he should. So he didn't really dominate the midfield. Dosi, to me, was my best player in the first half, locking up the runs on the sideline. Second half came in, and Quintero came in, changed the game. Coco came in as well. The second half a little bit better than the first half. But, you know, I think the team still has a lot of work to do. And the team needs to gel better because the Real Salt Lake team were not fantastic. They came like for a draw the way they played. They were not moving forward. At the same time, they were able to stop Dynamo from scoring a goal.
I mean, talking about the RSL team, this is a team that got to the Western Conference Finals last season. They lost to Portland Timbers. This is just the way they played. It was a fairy tale run. You know, before they know it, they became giant killers in the Western Conference and boom, they're in the finals. But I think tonight, some fans think like a deja vu that they've seen this kind of thing before. You know, as we spoke to some on the hallway, they felt that it's a deja vu. We've seen it before. One said that he came to see explosive, you know, excitement, you know, but he just saw a kind of a lackluster team, which I said, not really, because some players are still getting into their groove. You know, when they play regularly together, they can understand each other. But why didn't we see Tyler Pasha tonight?
Honestly, I don't know why, but the coach definitely has his reasons why he didn't put Tyler. I felt Tyler would have come in the second half to add more bites on the wing. We all know Tyler to be a very fast-paced player. And having Fafa Picard on the right and Tyler on the left is just an explosive attack you want to see. And the coach went for attacking formation. If you notice the game, the coach went for a 4-3-3 formation. So that showed the guys really wanted to score goals. But not having Fafa Tyler on your right, I don't know, he knows better about that. But I would have put Burton Tyler, if nothing else, in the second half to play with Fafa.
But right now, the coach is yet to really establish his starting 11.
True.
You know, but when you saw the two, you know, the substitution he made in the second half, when Dominic Quintero came on, when Coco came on, I think there was a little bit of energy in that middle, you know.
Yeah.
To my own opinion, I don't think Darwin Sirin should be starting ahead of Coco or Darwin Quintero, in my own opinion.
Very true. Coco was very exciting today. You saw his flair of the game, touching the passes, the way he carried the ball, the way he moved. He was just exciting. You know, I wish he started. If Coco started the first half, maybe the game would have been a different story. Because if you notice, the second half, Dynamo struck the ball twice. One from Fafa Picó and Quintero.
Quintero.
Yeah.
Look at them, Lindquist, you know, tried to do
it was close. Well, good save. Yeah, keeper. Yeah, save. Yeah, yeah. Adam Lindquist was also very good. In the second half, he was my man of the second half. Locked down the defense completely. Even when they brought in, Rosoke brought in Cardoza, the big guy, you know, how big and strong. Yeah, but Adam was able to lock him down, and, you know, he wasn't as dangerous as we would have expected him to be.
But I think Dynamo still need one or two attacking pieces, because sometimes when you have a deep squad and when you come up across a team that defend deep, soaking your pressure, you know, you look at your bench, you know, who am I going to bring on to unlock this resilient team? When you look at Dynamo bench tonight, you know, aside from Coco, Quintero, who came on to, you know, effect change in the game, who do you think could have come on to effect the change? I don't know. So I think they need like two attacking pieces, you know. to have a very deep squad.
You know what I think Dynamo needs?
What?
Dynamo needs to sign a big name.
A big name. A
That's it, because the team is just a bunch of average players. They need a big name, an exciting player. If they can secure the signing of a HH that would be a big deal, because I see that he's might be old, but he's still playing Atletico Madrid and he's doing very well. Even he just played the last Champions League game against Manchester United.
Yeah.
So if he's in this team, I foresee him solidifying the midfield, and you know, it's just he will change a lot of things if they can bring him to this team.
I think also they need that fear factor.
Yes, yeah, the superstar. He's more well experienced. He's played in different clubs.
You go to LA Galaxy now. You think about
Diego Costa.
Diego Costa.
Amazing combinations.
Look at Carlos Vela, scoring
hat trick.
First game,
yeah.
Got a hat trick
against Colorado Rapids.
So when you look at the Western Conference, all the teams in the West. Nashville crossed from east to west. You know what Nashville did last season? Hanne Mukhtar was their star.
Yeah.
Now they play in the West. When you look at how competitive the Western Conference is, and when you look at the Eastern Dynamo, you know, what comes to your mind?
It's going to be a struggle again this season. Honestly, I want the best of Dynamo. I really want them. I think they're a good team.
I really want them.
I want them, but I think it's going to be a struggle. But I think it's going to be a struggle because the competition in the Western Conference, like you said, is just amazing. The quality of players in the Western Conference. They're players that have not just played the game, they have won a lot of the game. Diego Costa has won the Champions League with Bayern Munich. Chicharito appeared in Real Madrid. And David Vela, you know, just everybody has all the teams. You know what I mean? All these teams have depth. All the players are well experienced. They have done it before. They know how to win. There's no winner in this Dynamo team. Let's be honest. Even the coach is more like is more like in training, because he hasn't coached any MLS team before. He was an assistant coach.
I mean, let's talk about the coach. I mean, those who may watch this team may think we are being too critical of the coach. Or they might think we're just, you know, not bringing a good vibe, or like, you know, not trying to have a good omen or good outlook about it. But sometimes, you know, you just have to be factual. When you look at Tab Ramos when he came on, from national team setup assistant coach to Jurgen Klinsmann, or he's been in the U.S. national team setup for a long time, I think they could have supported him with the investment they are doing right now. Because he spent two seasons with the team, right? I think the players have said to understand him, you know, understand what he wants, how he wants to play. So I think they should have, the club hierarchy should have, you know, back him up the way they are backing up the present coach. I think also, you know, I remember when I asked Pat Onstad, you know, are we not making the same mistake again? You know, he said no. The difference is that this new person, you know, work with players day in, day out. But the former guy work with players like two or three times in 6 months when they come together for national team assignment. It's a different thing. But at the end of the day, he's a rookie coach in the league. This is fourth season as a head coach of an MLS franchise. The league is not where you allow a coach to train. No. I get it. Sometimes a new coach who hasn't been in the league might come in and make wonders. But look at coaches that have won laurels in the league, like Bruce Arena, like Bob Bradley. You know, all these coaches are veteran in the league. They understand how the game is played in the league. You know, so really and truly, I don't know. Just
well, I understand your concerns and the fact that what you said is nothing but the truth. But this is the first game. What's his name? LAFC did the same. What's it called? They tried the same gamble as well. It worked out. The first game they won 3-0. The coach at Barney was coaching Las Vegas Light in the USL, and he came in first time. He played for, I think, the Swedish national team or so. I don't know, but he played the World Cup for a national team. That's Sweden or Germany. I'm not sure, but he was coaching Las Vegas Light. And they brought him from Las Vegas, like, straight to become the head coach of LAFC. And on their first game, what happened? Vela scored a hat trick that beat Colorado Rapids 3-0.
You have Vela in this team?
That's what I'm saying. That's why I don't want to hammer more on the coaching side. I know he's a rookie, but I think Dynamo needs a special player. If they can secure the signing of HH, I think Herrera will do a whole lot to this team. It will change the dynamics of the team because they need a leader. There's no leader in this team. That's what you see, like Adam Parker. They're all playing.
Team Parker.
But they need a leader figure. You can tell everyone is just playing.
That's what this team lacks right now.
If they can get a leader, I can tell you the energy is going to be different. The excitement is going to be more. Everybody want to play more and give more, you know?
I think overall the fans weren't really disappointed.
Yeah, because they didn't lose.
They are still hurt.
Yeah.
You know, they didn't lose their tie. Mm. At least they gave them something to cheer about.
Yeah.
You know? But now they go on the road next weekend against Sporting Kansas. He is going back to where he started.
Yeah. That's going to be interesting.
Very interesting. Back to Sporting Kansas, where you come from, mm-hmm. You know. So I think having worked with the Sporting Kansas organization, he can really give them insight of what to expect. Even though, yes, Sporting Kansas and Dynamo are two different teams, they know themselves.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah,
in the Western Conference.
Yeah.
But overall, give your pass mark to the team tonight.
Well, I would give them a six.
A six?
Yeah, I give them a six because of what they had good ball possession. They were controlling the game, which really showed that the team is beginning to gel. But I didn't like the fact that they were not able to really carry the ball from the midfield to attack. The attack was flat all through. The attempt on goals came from a defender and one midfielder and one right wing player. No striker, no ten. It was kind of flat. But towards the end of the second half, the momentum started to come up after the changes came up with Coco and Quartero.
What about the new goalkeeper, Steve Clark?
Well, there was no test in the game team this throughout the game.
In the
58 minute, yeah. Save. Yeah. Let's see how it goes.
This is around the MLS with Simon Chris on Africa Sports Network. We're chopping up and breaking down the second 45 minutes between Houston Dynamo and Real Salt Lake. At the end of the day, the game ended 0-0. None of them were able to break the deadlock. So they are going back home with a point. Yes, decent for Real Salt Lake, a road game, you know, for the home team. They were expecting 3 points, but it didn't happen. Day before the head coach, Paul Nakamura. Next week, he will go back to Sporting Kansas, where he started from. And like my man Chris said, we're going to see what happens. So Chris, what's your hot take on today?
My hot take today is a better game next time.
Three points,
hopefully, next game.
So we'll see you again. Keep watching. Around the MLS.
With African Sports Network.
With Sam and Chris.
That's it. Keep the dial. And make sure you subscribe after watching this, okay?
Yes.
We need your subscription.
If I forget, listen, look at something else.
Subscribe.
So, man.